Hey there guys, my name is Brandon and welcome to the video. If it has to deal with the Phoenix Suns, I'm probably going to make a video about it. And you guys, before this video gets started, I just wanted to let you guys know that my last upload was on May 23rd. And ever since then, I have been a little bit sick. My voice has been really scratchy. It's been really shot. But I am basically better. So if my voice sounds a little bit weird in this video, I do apologize. So with that being said, it is being reported that the Phoenix Suns are open to trading the 6th overall pick in the 2019 NBA draft. And I just thought I'd give you guys my thoughts and opinion. So with that being said, let's dive right into it. And you guys, before the NBA draft lottery, I said that if the Phoenix Suns do not get the number 1 or 2 overall pick, that they should trade it. I feel like this draft class is a little bit top heavy, but I do believe that this draft class down the road could be extremely talented and be very successful down the road. And I'll admit it, you guys, I totally overreacted to the Suns getting the 6th overall pick. And Monty Williams said something along the lines that it's not like it's the 26th pick, but it's the 6th overall pick, and it's still a very high and valuable draft pick. Now, you guys, the question is, if the Phoenix Suns do trade the 6th overall pick, who do they trade it for? And you guys, ever since the NBA trade deadline, the Phoenix Suns have been rumored and linked to so many NBA players. And I get it, it's just a bunch of rumors, but you name the player and the Phoenix Suns are somehow linked to that player. Anthony Davis, Kyrie Irving, Mike Conley, Lonzo Ball, Chris Paul, Ricky Rubio, George Hill, so many different players. And believe it or not, even Kevin Durant, and very, very recently, Julius Randle. You guys got to remember that the Phoenix Suns have been without a point guard for a couple of years now. Some of the point guards that the Phoenix Suns have recently had, Isaiah Kanan, Mike James, Tyler Ulis, Elfrid Payton, and Eli Okobo, DeAnthony Melton I'll throw in there. It has just been very unsuccessful, and it is no secret that the Phoenix Suns need a point guard, they need a ball handler, and Devin Booker and DeAndre Ayton need some more help. Well, you guys, here's another thing. I do feel like this NBA offseason is going to be absolute chaos, and I've said this the past couple offseasons regarding the Phoenix Suns. The Phoenix Suns have endless possibilities to what they could do, and anything could happen. They do not have to trade this 6th overall pick for a point guard. There is a little bit of free agency options, but I feel like the Phoenix Suns have a lot of trade packages. So even if they do throw in the 6th overall pick in a trade package and get a point guard either after the draft or on draft day, I feel like that is a possibility. But you guys, please leave me your thoughts, comments, and opinions down below. What should the Phoenix Suns do with the 6th overall pick? Should the Phoenix Suns keep the 6th overall pick and draft a player? Let me know in the comments down below. But you guys, if you made it this far into the video, type in NBA draft June 20th, and that way I can see if you guys made it far into the video. And also guys, I do apologize for the sound of my voice, but I am so excited for the month of June. I have so many videos planned, especially before the NBA draft and after the NBA draft. So please subscribe to Suns Geek. My name is Brandon. Please subscribe for everything Phoenix Suns. If it has to deal with the Phoenix Suns, I'm probably going to make a video about it, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks so much for watching, guys.